So Dr. Scholz, this patient had a prostatectomy in 2014. The PSA was negligible and then recently went up to 0.2 and then 0.18 and now 0.24. His doctor suggested he gets an Axumin scan. However, his support group leader says that his PSA is too low to get a good result from an Axumin scan and wants to know if he should get a PSMA. What's your opinion?
I would agree with the support group leader. The PSMA PET scans can detect stuff as low as PSAs of 0.2, which is really amazing for me. The Axumin PET scans work better when the PSA is over 1. So we're hopeful that the PSMA PET scans will be widely available in the marketplace this year. It is available at some of the different academic centers right now, and I agree. Get a scan, and that the PSMA PET scan is the best one.
Now, for the centers where the PSMA scan is available, are there certain criteria a patient needs to have in order to get that scan, or can anybody just get a PSMA scan with that trial?
The patients have to have prostate cancer, and right now, because of the payment situation, these scans are costing up to $3,000 sometimes. If you're willing to write a check, you can get a scan for the most part.
What precisely is micrometastasis, like aka micromets, and how is it related to systemic prostate cancer?
So metastasis means spots of cancer away from the prostate, outside the prostate. Micro means that they're too small to be seen on a scan. So we're seeing smaller and smaller spots now with the new PSMA PET scans, perhaps down to 2 or 3 millimeters, but you know, cancer cells are much smaller than that. And so if someone has a scan of their body that shows there's no metastasis, unfortunately, that's not proof that there's no metastasis. It is possible to have microscopic specks of cancer outside the prostate that are invisible to the best available scans. This is an important concept because in men who are predicted to have a high incidence of micrometastasis, say Gleason 9 or high PSAs when they're diagnosed, there are treatments such as hormone therapy and chemotherapy that might be able to eliminate them and take someone who would otherwise relapse in the future and turn them into a cure. This concept of giving adjuvant systemic therapy with hormones or chemotherapy is routine in lung cancer, breast cancer, colon cancer, and is certainly part of the idea of giving hormone treatment to men with high-risk disease as men are managed presently. So it's all driven by the thought that there may be microscopic metastasis outside the prostate somewhere. And the hope is that right now is the time to try and cure it.
So our next question is, what will the future of mpMRI look like so that occult cancers no longer are an issue? Is it to move to 5T? Maybe we get a bigger magnet like 7T? Or would it be like a contrasting agent like MT218?
So I think your questioner is calling occult cancers. What they're saying is that MRI can miss small, clinically significant cancers. So how are we ever going to make the MRI perfect? And we know that we don't have any perfect treatment right now. The random biopsy, which was the standard for many years, is not perfect. About 20% of cancers are missed on random biopsies. And perhaps in a well-performed modern multiparametric MRI, maybe 5 to 10% of cancers could be missed. What is neglected in this argument is that MRIs can be repeated annually, and the small tumors that might be missed can then be picked up if they continue to grow over time and still diagnosed at a curable stage. What's also missed in this type of an argument is that we know that we've been over-treating prostate cancer for so long, and there have been a tremendous number of men herded into unnecessary surgery and radiation for little tiny tumors that, in many cases, would never have turned into a problem. So I think we've already arrived. I think if you are dealing with a center that knows how to do the MRIs properly, I think if there's careful follow-up on an annual basis, that we don't need 7T MRIs and whatnot to protect people from missed cancers. I think they'll get picked up over time and they'll still be curable when they're detected. The next level of investigation, I think, for scanning will be the PSMA PET scans. So men that have MRIs, maybe there's a 5 to 10% chance that we're missing some cancer somewhere, a small tumor that could be detected the next year. But the PSMA PET scans have about similar ability to find cancer now and perhaps miss 5 to 10% of cancers in the prostate as well. So you've got two different independent witnesses now, MRI and PSMA PET. And if either one is only missing at 5 to 10% of the time, that means you're getting up close to probably 98% sensitivity for finding any small cancer. I think we're in a pretty strong position.
I like what you said about we have arrived and when it comes to wanting the accuracy of these scans, because I think that patients think that the technology is not out there, but the problem is just a lot of people don't know that these technologies are out there. I know PSMA is new, but a lot of people don't also know that they need to pay attention to the 3T versus the 1.5 and look for these quality centers. So I think it's very important that patients go and talk to other patients about this and in support groups and online so that we get that message out there. Obviously, that's what PCRI's passion is. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for new prostate cancer videos every week, and visit our website, pcri.org, because we have all sorts of prostate cancer information that can help you. We hope you have a great week.